An aggressive fish which poses a threat to wildlife wherever it goes is marching straight towards Australia and scaring a lot of ecologists on the way. That's right, I said marching, because this fish walks. One scientist told The Guardian not long ago that the arrival of the perch would be a major disaster for native fish, turtles, and even birds. Now, I told you it walks, Madison, right? So I gotta show you it walking for you to believe me. We have a video here. Check out the fish, the evil perch in action. Here he is making his way along. Okay, I played him out to be a scary guy, but it'll take him about 20 minutes to cross the street. But there he goes. He uses these little spine-like spikes which get into the ground, and that allows him to kind of waddle his way through. And that's perhaps what one of the reasons why this fish actually poses a threat. One, because it can do the ocean, it can do land as well. It can live for a week out of the water, which is incredible. It can live in salt water, fresh water. It could live in 6 months in muddy marshes. So it doesn't even have to be fully submerged in water. If it's got a little bit of mud moisture, it can live there for months on end. That's reason number one. Reason number two why ecologists are terrified by this tiny 2-inch fish is because if it's swallowed by a different animal, like a bird or a turtle or even another fish or a turtle, bird, I said, it blows up and it gets big like a puffer fish inside of that animal's throat and it kills them. And they come in such large abundance that they're such easy prey too, because you see how it's walking, it's easy, it's prey for any bird. They'll essentially automatically die. The second it gets swallowed, he blows up. Sometimes they can get out, they'll survive. If not, they're both dead. So that can potentially devastate the wildlife in Australia.
I mean, it's fascinating, the evolution of this fish for it to be able to survive out of water, to walk. I mean, these are all things that is really amazing, but it's too bad. And to be able to survive, it's basically protecting itself if anybody does eat them, that essentially is going to die. So it's fascinating that this fish has been able to become so powerful, but it's sad too, I guess, because it could hurt a lot of other animals in the process.
Yeah, I mean, it is natural though, right? Yeah. These migrations of bird, you might think, but it's not. They are now in Papua New Guinea, right? Which is not very far from Australia. The fish itself cannot swim that far. They can't migrate on their own. Although the bright orange is Papua New Guinea, below it obviously Australia. They can't migrate that far, but they're thinking that this crafty perch can come on fishing boats. They can stick to the bottom of fishing boats. They'll even be caught as live bait, and then when they see a small little perch, they'll discard it, they'll throw it off the boat. So it does have means of getting to Australia. They found a few in the vicinity, and they're thinking the numbers might grow, and once that happens, we'll see a huge decline in things like turtles, other certain fish, and even birds. According to one expert, he said when they populate an area they're not commonly found in, they can disrupt the entire balance of that habitat, which is pretty big. I mean, given that it's a small little fish, looks like any other fish, but poses a huge threat to an entire habitat. We want to know what you guys have to say about this evil walking fish. Post your comments below, and if you haven't already, please subscribe to the Lip TV for more.